Hello everybody, this is Hamid Doost Mohammadian, Professor for Sustainability and Cultural Dimensions. In this video, I'm going to talk about the theory called the Fifth Wave. I have invented this theory in 2010, and as I said in last video, because of the lack of knowledge, that time I could not develop the model and the theory. But after 2016, after the new methodologies and the topic like Society 5.0 and topic like Industry 4.0 and the other topic like virtual reality, genetics, biotechnologies, AI, and etc., I could develop my model and my theory. I'm going to publish a book very soon about this theory. If you remember, in other videos, I discussed about Elvin Toffler and his book in 1917 called The Third Wave. Also another book of him about the future shock. In this book, he said, we passed three different waves. The first wave was the agriculture age, something like 50 to 70,000 years. The second wave was industrial age, like 300 years after the 17th century. And the third wave was post-industrial age, since 1970 to something like 2000 or 2006. And also, in another sector, from the second wave, from these 300 years, we had two industries, or industrial revolution. Industry 1.0, mechanization, steam power, chemical invention. Industry 2.0, mass production, assembly line, electrical energy, and etc. And then, after 1969, that happened the post-industrial age, or the next revolution, Industry 3.0, automation, computers, electronic, ARPANET, the father of internet. And then, today, we say we are in Industry 4.0, because we are in this, something like cyber physical systems, Internet of Things, networks, neural networks, artificial intelligence, smartness, digitalization, ubiquitous, and etc. If you look at the business from the small medium sized enterprises, in the third wave we had SMEs 3.0, and in fourth wave today we have the SME 4.0. But in my model, I'm going to talk about tomorrow, because we are going to fifth wave. In fifth wave, we are starting from the edge of tomorrow, and then tomorrow shock. Because if we cannot prepare ourselves for tomorrow, we are going to have some challenges. For example, low sustainability. We know for sustainability we have two different views. One is livability and quality of life. Another one is another model called 7 PS. According to my model, 7 PS, 7 pillars of sustainability, we have 7 factors. Social, political, educational, cultural, technology, economy, and environmental. These 7 factors also can influence our business. That's why we need to prepare ourselves for tomorrow. Here, we have something very important besides the technology and the smartness. This is the human resource and human resource competencies. Because we need to find how this human resource can face with the future. Also, we need to make levels for them. Public sector, normal people, and the rest of the people, experts. In the next videos, I will talk about this kind of levels for human resource competencies, and then I will explain for you which kind of competencies are important for them to face with future and using these new technologies after SME 4.0 and Industry 4.0. Because this is very important to understand, tomorrow and the edge of tomorrow, HR is first important point. In next videos, I will talk about this fifth theory more, and also more details about human resource competencies for future and tomorrow. Thank you.